Hey everybody, Christopher Odd here, and this is it! This is the farewell bonus episode of Life is Strange, Before the Storm. Now, if you didn't know, the original voice actresses are back. We have Hannah Telly. Is it Telly or just Tell? I'm actually not sure. And we have Ashley Birch, of course. I'm pretty sure we play as Max in this scenario. We play as younger girls, like, before any of this stuff went down. So as I always try to do in the Life is Strange games, I'm gonna try to revert my age by 20 years and try to identify as a young adult female. Turns out I'm pretty good at that, okay? Just saying. Let's start the episode and prepare for feels. Gonna say we've changed a bit there, but we're strapped onto dynamite, the Barbies.
Ready, I guess.
Oh wow!
But isn't your mom gonna freak? She's probably cooking with the radio on. She won't hear a thing. I bet she'll notice a hole in the floor. Trust in science, Max. Even when science means blowing shit up.
Oh man, they're young. This is gonna go great. Don't stay back. Yep.
Tell me that wasn't the coolest thing you've ever seen.
It was pretty good.
That was truly amazing. Why are explosions so awesome?
That's like asking, why are puppies cute? Some things just are.
She looks so different.
I'm not sure your mom would see it that way.
When she asked me to get rid of my old junk, she never specified how. But I guess I better do some actual cleaning too. I'll be excavating the closet. If you see anything else to trash, help a girl out and chuck it on the pile over there.
Okay, good. I would love to clean the room first. That's a great warm-up. I honestly no idea where this is gonna go. I don't know if we're gonna have any of our powers.
Like I spent half my life hanging out in this room. Probably because I have. I can't believe those days are all over now.
There's probably going to be so many things that were like...
My whole family moves to Seattle. I have no idea when I'll see Chloe again. This could be my last chance to say goodbye.
I wonder how many things are going to be...
How do you tell your best
referenced
friend
here
that you're leaving her?
That... Because we've played the previous games... We're like, oh, that's how it started. You know, I'm probably gonna miss so many of them, but.
I better help Chloe with her cleaning. And while I'm at it, I can take one long last look around this place.
Barbie
Live
parts?
Fast, die young, and go out with a bang. Rest in pieces, doll. Chloe's had this hung up on her wall forever, but neither of us can figure out what happened to the last panel. I hope Dr. Kloenstein's okay.
Our crime fighting has really soared since you created these rocket boosters. Of course, the power of flight does tend to make things easier. Dr. Kloenstein? I imagine maybe we can find this later.
Chloe's mom wanted us to go through this pile of old clothes and find stuff to donate. Instead, we played dress up for an hour.
Classic us.
Chloe's always preferred imaginary animals to real ones. Well, besides Bongo, of course. Chloe and I haven't played this game in forever.
And I'm pretty sure it's missing pieces.
Is that like trouble? I guess we trash that. She'd be like, nope, not that one. It's my favorite board game.
What are you doing?
Adding this to the pile.
No freaking way. Just because I beat your ass every time we play doesn't make it trash.
Yeah, see? You beat me? I don't know about that.
That's BS. The last time we played, I wiped the floor with you.
Poor Max. Losing your memory at such a young age. Guess we'll have to play again soon and find out.
Classic. We're not going to be throwing anything out.
This was our first unsupervised concert together. It was so much fun. We were supposed to see another show next month, but...
How sick was that show?
The sickest.
I've been working on my moves for the next one. Check it out.
Oh yeah, super hip. Those are sweet moves.
How about you? Any new moves?
Obviously.
Yeah, totally. I've been working on my air guitar.
Damn, Caulfield. Save something for when it counts.
Yeah, seriously.
All right, back to the junk mines.
Let this box of trash be a sacrifice to you, O almighty Chloe Bear. As usual, Chloe's grades are better than mine. I still kick her butt in PE, though.
That report card has changed considerably over time. Let's not lie down just yet. So how old are we here? Hold on. Does it say what grade
as
we're in?
As usual, Chloe's grades
eighth
are
grade,
than
so
mine.
We're what, 14?
I still kick her butt in PE, though.
Yeah. It's usually grade, like, 6, it's about 12, 13, yeah, so about 14, 13 to 15, I guess, if you had to be on the ranges. Ooh. Oh, we can't trash Menagerie of Magic.
Chloe's magic phase with all my fingers intact.
She's not going to want to throw that
this
either.
Seems like a good candidate.
Are you insane? That's my entire magic collection. Do you know how many weeks of allowance this cost?
You don't ever use it. It's not lame. I love magic.
You haven't touched these since the fifth grade talent show.
Maybe because my assistant turned out to be squeamish at the sight of fake blood.
At least you didn't saw me in half. How are you planning to clean this place if you won't throw away anything?
A magician never reveals her secrets. Put it back.
Okay. We're not, as I said, we're not getting nothing is getting thrown out here. Not a single thing.
What's your dad's camera doing in here?
Dad said I could bring it up here for you to use. He's tired of watching you drool all over yourself every time he uses it. His words.
Your dad is the best.
Sure. Just don't ever tell him that. We need to keep him on his toes. You're off to a great start.
Actually...
That's how it all began. Cool. That's how it all began right there.
I bet Chloe's parents were freaking out when she got this letter.
Your child, Chloe Price, has been accepted for a September 2008 admission to Blackwell Academy. We've offered places to approximately 100 students out of 1,200 applicants. Your child excelled in all criteria for admission. That's less than 10%, guys. An open house for admitted students and parents will be held on March 26th. April 2nd is the deadline to inform us of your intentions regarding admission. Your admission reply form is included. For those who require financial aid, please contact Blackwell's office for financial assistance. Look forward to welcoming you and Chloe to the Blackwell Academy.
I still can't believe you're a Blackwell Academy student. How is it?
Oh, the classes are incredible. The teachers are actually smart. And the lab is legit. Petri dishes for days.
What about the students? Are they as stuck up as you thought they'd be?
They're fine.
Come on.
Chloe, you're terrible at hiding your feelings. Is everything okay?
I don't know, I like hanging out with normal people. Like you.
Thanks. I guess.
You know what I mean. I hate fake people. You're real.
Thanks.
I like that.
People say a lot of things about
Chloe Price by generous family, donation from the Prescott Foundation.
This is pretty cool.
It's so interesting. There's going to be a lot of
That was awesome.
Opinions that changed dramatically from this age to what we experienced last.
Pyrotechnical adventure. I think Chloe used to call this guy Mr. Sharky. I doubt she plays with it anymore.
Yeah, Chloe, Mr. Sharky can go. Come on now.
You better not be thinking. I think you are.
No, never mind.
Chloe, I haven't seen you touch this guy in years. Why do you care?
Why do I care? If you throw my beloved childhood friend into the trash? I don't think that deserves an answer.
That explains a lot about her, hey? Like,
sorry, chum. That's better.
As kind of nonchalant and...
I can go tell Chloe I'm done arguing about trash with her.
As nonchalant and kind of apathetic she appears in the future, she's always had that root of, like, she just can't let go of things that happened in the past, right? And, like,
Chloe's
even that...
Chloe's been beating me for a while, but that growth spurt could come any day now.
Yeah, it could happen.
We bought this as a gag years ago. I honestly can't believe Chloe still has it.
Let's try this one.
What about this half-eaten jawbreaker? A serious biohazard.
You promised me we'd finish it together no matter how long it took. Don't be a quitter.
I'm licking it.
You're right.
Yes! The never-ending candy lives on.
That's it. I'm calling off the search. If you want more trash, you'll have to find it yourself.
Well, it wasn't exactly the purge Mom was hoping for, but...
Well, maybe if you'd...
tried, right?
Let go of some feelings.
And now we've got the whole day ahead of us. What do two under-supervised friends with clean rooms and clean slates want to get into today?
I guess now would be a good time to tell Chloe I'm leaving. Or I could let us enjoy the day first and tell her later.
I always struggle with this. Like, I'm the type of person who likes to rip off the Band-Aid. But then we might ruin the day. We could have a great day, and then we could tell her. I'm gonna tell her later, but then she'll be like, why didn't you just tell me? I'm gonna shoot her straight. Oh God.
Actually.
Brace for impact.
Chloe, I really have to tell you something. It's, I don't know how
Holy
to.
Shit. Max, hold that thought.
Can't tell her anyway.
Must have fallen out when I was digging around in here. Do you have any idea what this is?
It's definitely pirate related.
Whatever it is, it looks like it came out of our pirate phase.
Your powers of deduction are as strong as ever. This tape is from 5 years ago. It's a message from our past selves to our current selves.
Oh, cool.
So we were 8 years old.
So they're 13.
Crazy.
Nailed it.
I can't even imagine what we sounded like.
13 to 15.
Ready to find out?
That's a young grade 8.
Avast, future wayfarer! Ye have uncovered the audio log of the most fearsome pirates in the bays of Arcadia! Captain Bluebeard and Longneck Silver!
You are such dorks. So,
you're in search of buried treasure, are ye? Well, if it's treasure ye seek,
do mine eyes spot two fair pirate wenches? What?
Dad, get away! We're in the middle of an important project!
Oh, a project? Never mind then. I apologize.
I mean it!
All right. Supper's in 5. Wash your hands, you grubby pirate kids.
So lame. As I was saying, if it's treasure you seek, you've come to the right place. But be forewarned, the journey will be treacherous and full of treachers.
Nice.
To find the treasure of Price Isle, you will need the map from the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard. Only the map can lead ye to the treasure ye seek. But be forewarned. Again, only those with pure hearts will be able to see.
It's quite the pirate face.
The amulet.
Good luck. And, bye.
Nailed the closing. That's good.
Dude, that was...
all of the above, actually.
Amazing. I can't believe you still have that.
I would never throw away something so precious. Okay, forget everything. Today, we go treasure hunting. I think I know what 8-year-old you meant by the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard.
Our old sketchbook. This is where we kept all our pirate drawings.
Interesting.
Yep. Now let's see this map.
So not only are we playing much younger group, it seems like we're revisiting stuff that we did like 5 years prior even, which is kind of cool. Crow's Nest, Saloon, the Bane of Arcadia, Cockpit, Galley, Cannons, Treasure Keep, Plank. Bluebeard and Longneck Silver. We look like Toy Story characters. Don't we like the... Yeah, we totally do. Oh, Pogo and the gang. Okay, these are the pirate rules, and these are very important. First of all, no bathing. Second of all, no boys on the ship. Ew. Third, no sharing pirate secrets. Obviously, it doesn't even need to be a rule. Four, always share plunder. Good. It's in the contracts. That's important. Always bury treasure. Where else are we going to hide it? Always protect fellow pirates. I mean... It's kind of like the same as number 4. Failure to obey these rules will result in plank walking. Yeah, okay, but that kind of goes against always protecting fellow pirates, but, you know, I get it. They break the rule, they die. Captain's Log. Another day of plunder and destruction on the high seas. Our just buried treasure has come under attack again. The evil commander Shelley, enemy to all pirates, has threatened to take the map from us if she sees it. Surely she has heard how valuable our treasure is and wants to steal it from us. We're doing our best to keep the map hidden as we continue to work on it. Because our enemies want our treasure so bad, we must make sure the map is only readable to us. Captain Bluebeard and Long Mac Silver. To more plunder and riches, Captain Bluebeard, Long Mac Silver.
This looks like a page was ripped out. I wonder if it's the map.
Classic us. Ripping out pages that are very important.
Hey, check this out. This page was ripped out. Do you think it's the map?
If it is, there's no way I would have thrown it out. Maybe it's mixed in with the rest of the drawings?
Maybe it's where the missing panel is from...
So much for telling Chloe now. All she cares about is finding this map. But where could it be? Don't move. This angle is perfect.
Why be shy? Get in here, dude.
Yeah. Together is better.
Subject and photographer. You really do it all, Max.
That is actually, that's a cool angle to get both in there too, to be fair. Make your own story.
Chloe and I were doing a lot of drawing in Miss Shelley's class.
Great job as always, Chloe. Now, please.
If the map is mixed in with her school supplies from that year.
Try to pay attention in class instead of drawing pictures with Maxine. Oh, there's Shelley as well, the social studies teacher. That's good. Okay, so what do we have going on here?
I remember writing this. It's a story where you choose what happens. Wonder if I could still get to the end.
I wonder at this timeline, those books would have been, those books would have been around. Mm. Like the Choose Your Own Adventure books, and they made their own. So you're Max and Chloe, the best friends and students in school. You sit in class until suddenly a cute squirrel arrives at the window. Disaster. It is so cute. Do you want to pet it? Do we pet the squirrel or do we not pet the squirrel? We definitely pet the squirrel. So we want to go to page 8. You go to the window and pet the squirrel. Of course, why wouldn't you? It's a cute squirrel and you want to pet it. Hey, Mr. Squirrel, you say. Oh, stop biting me, you say next, because the squirrel is now biting your hand. But it's too late. You have rabies. Mrs. Anders says to shoot you so you don't bite anyone else. This makes her very sad. Guess you shouldn't have pet the squirrel. Damn it. I always was bad at these. Okay, let's not pet the squirrel and go to page 3. Why don't you like squirrels? They're so cute and nice. You must be very mean. The squirrel seems annoyed that you ignored her. She runs in and steals the book report right off your desk and then runs back outside. That squirrel stole my book report, you tell the teacher. Mm-hmm. Whatever you say, Mrs. Anders responds, clearly not believing you. What do? Well, we obviously chase the squirrel. As soon as Mrs. Anders turns around, you run out of the window and chase the squirrel. It's a very bad thing to do, and you hope you don't get in trouble. But you will. You probably will. Outside, you look around, but you can't find the squirrel. Is she gone? Well, there she is. She's standing next to a sewer hole. You run up to her, but she gets scared and jumps down. Oh, boy, do you really want to go down there? Yes, jump down the sewer. You are very stupid brave. You leap down to the sewer. Thankfully, there's a pile of trash, banana peels, and dirty diapers to land on. Oh, thank God. You hear a squirrel running around in the distance, so you run to follow it. There are many twists and turns. Eventually, you come to a fork in the road. Now's not the time for eating. So you put the fork back down and consider the two paths in front of you. On the ground, you see a trail of tiny footprints to the left and a trail of chewed up paper to the right. Which way do you go? I think we go to the right, page 7. Smart choice. Oh God. You go to the right following the path of the chewed papers. After a bit of walking, you end up in a dark corner. Suddenly the floors fall away. You find yourself swimming in some sort of warm liquid, almost like a big puddle. Except, why does this liquid taste like acorns? A bright light comes on. It turns out you're not in a puddle, you're in a big bowl of acorn soup, and all around you are squirrels holding spoons and wearing tiny little aprons. They look cute. And the soup keeps getting hotter. Guess you weren't too smart after all. At least you'll be delicious. This is pretty good, actually. How many are there? You decide to burn the Rat King's throne. Oh, cool. This is so inventive, Maxine and Chloe, but next time, please do the book report you were assigned.
Oh, yes!
That's cool.
Take that, Rat King.
That's cool. Okay, well, like... are you seeing anything? We can only look at these,
Chloe's
right?
Chloe's mom wanted us to go through this pile of old clothes and find stuff to donate. Instead, we played dress-up for an hour.
Yeah, okay.
Chloe's so determined to find the map. I love any luck.
Oops.
Nope. You?
Nothing yet.
Okay.
This looks like a page was ripped out. I wonder if it's the map.
She's gonna be like, I'm looking for the map and you're just chilling? Come on.
It's so hard to believe. This room, this house, this town. All in the past now. Or soon to be. Who even am I without Chloe? She's the one who's always starting.
Where could that map be?
Pulling us into adventures.
Maybe it's mixed in with Chloe's old books.
I can't imagine life without her. Maybe I haven't told her.
Got lots on our mind.
Because I still can't believe it's real myself.
Thank you. Whew. This is gonna be. There's.
Chloe has a lot of her old school supplies.
Maybe. Do we check the backpack?
I should check those.
Is this. People this is not just the same thing?
People say a lot of things about the yeah. Prescott family, but. This is pretty cool.
Okay, let's find her supplies then, okay? It's not there. Oh, wait. Oh! Here we go. There it is. Sitting out there.
Bingo.
Okay, Chloe's secret lair, the amulet inside a dark cavern, Treasure Island, Price Castle. It's good, actually.
I'm remembering this now. Didn't we make some crazy puzzle? You need the telescope and the amulet,
which we hid inside a dark cavern, aka the attic.
Nailed it.
Why did we do that to ourselves?
Because we were 8 years old and the attic was the scariest place we could think of.
You think it's still scary?
Was. Your attic is still terrifying.
It's been 5 years, Max. I'm sure the boogeyman has died of starvation.
It's more the mice and spiders I'm afraid of.
Time to face your fears, then.
Okay, and once we have the amulet and the telescope, we use them to reveal the treasure. Somehow.
Okay, so we're doing this. Happening.
I'll head to the garage to dig up my old telescope. You go find that amulet. We'll meet out back at the pirate ship.
You mean the swings?
Yes, the pirate ship. Captain Bluebeard and Long Max Silver right again, bitches!
That's exactly what the pirates would have said.
I'll find a way to tell Chloe later. If this has to be my last day here, might as well have one final pirate adventure. Okay, Chloe said she hid the amulet in the attic. The only way in is through the broom closet.
Okay, well, I think this is a good place to take a break, guys. I'll be doing these probably like 25, 30 minute chunk every day until it's done. I imagine it's roughly the same length as a normal episode. So probably get like either 4 to 5, you know, parts, I would guess. But I want to take my time with it, and considering this is going to be like the last Life is Strange thing, I think it's we owe it, you know. It's an amazing experience, so I'm gonna treat it as such. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next one. Okay,
place in the house, but
bye.